Welcome to this quick guide where I'm going to show you how to create a Windows 11 bootable USB flash drive using the Microsoft Media Creation tool. And if you get any value out of this video, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. But to get started with the guide, if you want to create a Windows 11 bootable USB flash drive with the Media Creation tool, the first thing that you'll need is a blank USB flash drive that's at least 8 gigs in size, or just a USB flash drive that doesn't contain any important files that you don't mind formatting. Once you have that, you can plug it into your computer, and then you can go ahead and open up a browser on your computer, and then do a Google search for download Windows 11, and you should get this Microsoft webpage, which says download Windows 11. You can go ahead and click on that, and you should get to the Microsoft software downloads page. Now right here, you can scroll down on this page until you get to this section that says Create Windows 11 Installation Media. Then you can click on Download Tool Now, and it's going to download the Windows 11 Media Creation Tool. Click on Open File to open it. And next, it's going to launch this Windows 11 Setup Wizard. Next, just click on Accept to accept the terms. Next, you'll need to choose the language and edition. I recommend that you just use the recommended options for this PC that you're currently using to create the bootable USB flash drive. But if you want to change these options, you can just deselect this checkbox. Then you can select another language, and the edition will just be Windows 11 64-bit, as there is no Windows 11 32-bit available. So I'm just going to select this checkbox again, then click on Next. And now you'll need to choose if you want to create a USB flash drive or just download the ISO file. We want to create a bootable USB flash drive, so just leave this USB flash drive option selected, then click on Next. And now you'll need to select the USB flash drive that you want to use. Now for me, I only have one option here, which is the USB flash drive that I plugged in earlier. And I also recommend that you just have one USB flash drive connected to your computer, the one that you want to use to create this Windows 11 bootable USB flash drive. And if you don't see it here, just click on Refresh Drive List and it should show up here. Then select it, then click on Next. And then first it's going to download the Windows 11 ISO file, and once that's finished, it'll automatically create the Windows 11 bootable USB flash drive. Now you can expect this process to take around 30 minutes or more, depending on your internet speed and the USB flash drive you use, so you'll just need to have some patience and wait for this to finish. Now once this whole process is finished, you're going to see this screen that says your USB flash drive is ready. You can just go ahead and click on Finish. And then that setup wizard should close automatically. Then if you go ahead and open up the File Explorer window on your computer and then click on this PC, you should see this new USB flash drive called ESD-USB. And if you double click on that, you should see all of these files and you should have this setup application. Now to boot from this USB flash drive, you'll need to go ahead and you'll need to restart your computer. Now, once you can select the boot device, you'll see that the USB flash drive shows two boot options. You'll have the normal legacy BIOS option that you can boot from, which is the one that I'm currently on now. And then you'll also have this UEFI option that you can choose. Now, it is quite important which one you select here. Basically, if you have a new computer, you'll be using the UEFI option. But if you have an old computer, you'll be using the normal boot option. And also, when you use the normal legacy boot option, the drive that you're installing Windows on will need to be using the MBR partition scheme. And if you use the UEFI boot option, the drive will need to use the GPT partition scheme. But I've got separate guides on my channel showing you step by step how you can install Windows 10 or Windows 11 on your computer. And I'm going to link those on the screen now, and you can go ahead and watch that if you need any help installing Windows on your computer. But I hope this guide has been useful. Please like the video, and I'll talk to you guys soon.